It's hard to think of a food more synonymous with summer in the United States than the good old-fashioned hot dog. Sure, they're not exactly fancy, but that's a big part of the food's appeal. Portable, savory, and perfect for grilling, this low-maintenance meat has long been a staple of backyard barbecues, baseball games, camping bonfires, and 4th of July cookouts. And no matter what they're made from, most hot dogs are easily identified by their oblong sausage shape and standard off-brown or pink color. But while these are probably the dogs you're most likely to find at stores and stadiums across the U.S., you might be in for a surprise if you pick one up in America's most northeasterly state. Here, one type of hot dog stands out from the rest. Maine's famous red snapper hot dogs, which are immediately recognizable due to their distinct red coloring. These unique red snapper hot dogs are found almost exclusively in Maine, where they are considered to be a beloved regional staple, although they've also been known to pop up in New England and North Dakota on occasion. They get their signature bright, vibrant red color from dyes such as red number 40, red number 3, or sodium nitrite, and are made with an all-natural lamb casing rather than synthetic ones, which delivers a pleasant snapping sensation when the hot dogs are bitten into. Red snappers are frequently served on warm top-split New England hot dog buns for a truly authentic Maine experience. Sean Smith, the director of sales and marketing at the Maine-based butcher shop W.A. Bean & Sons, calls the hot dogs a real source of regional pride for Mainers, and he would know. W.A. Bean & Sons has been producing hot dogs since 1912. They are now the only butcher shop left in the state manufacturing and distributing this regional favorite, making them the de facto authority on the topic. While these hot dogs are popular for their savory flavor and satisfying snap, the red coloring seems to be a bit of a mystery. Although fans of the brand see the color as little more than a fun way to set these Maine dogs apart from the rest, not many people seem to know where the tradition came from, or exactly why they're dyed such a distinctive color to begin with. Smith explains that the addition of red dye to the red snapper hot dogs was simply a marketing tactic meant to attract customers' attention towards their product and away from their competitors. He told Thrillist, "I wish I could hang my hat on something a little higher than that, but it really was just a marketing technique that became synonymous with this region." And Maine isn't the only place you're likely to see this clever marketing trick. In fact, it seems that selling sausages by dyeing them red is a tradition that can be traced back to 1920s Europe. Indeed, the red snapper's roots can possibly be traced to the Danish hudpusa, or red sausage.
I was dreaming about this on the train, right? This was the first thing I do when I come to Copenhagen.
These sausages were smoked and stuffed with pork meat and a variety of spices, including nutmeg, allspice, and cardamom. Butchers would dye their old sausages a bright red color to alert customers that these meats were being sold at a discount. Soon, the cheap red sausages were flying off the shelves, and today, hudpulsas are a popular street food in Denmark. They're usually served on a hot dog bun and topped with ketchup, mustard, Danish remoulade, onions, and sliced pickles. Although it's no longer used as an indication that the meat on sale is stale, the tradition of dyeing sausages red eventually made its way to the northeastern United States. And while its signature bright red color certainly helps the dog stand out on supermarket shelves today, W.A. Bean & Sons no longer need to rely on marketing gimmicks to sell the product. These red snapper hot dogs have been a beloved Maine staple for decades now, and they don't appear to be going anywhere anytime soon. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more MASH videos about your favorite regional foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.